In fact, our relationship with sound looks a little bit like this. We really have gone unconscious. Sound doesn't just affect our hormone secretions, it affects all of our bodily rhythms. Breathing, heart rate, even brain waves. Because we've learned, all of us, over hundreds of thousands of years, that when the birds are singing, we're safe. Birdsong makes a lot of people feel very secure, and it's only if it suddenly stops that you get that feeling of, oh, what happened? You cannot understand two people talking at the same time, or in this case, one person talking twice. Not possible. Even a woman cannot understand two people talking at the same time. Those are three very, very good sounds. They're all stochastic. That means comprising lots of individual random events. And we find stochastic sound quite pleasing. There are two things happening here. I'm sending, you're receiving. And we have to work on both of those. It is not to be taken for granted that when we send, we are received. Something in the region of 16 to 18% of the school population on any given day is dealing with a hearing impairment. Most of it temporary, but it's there nevertheless. That's a big chunk of people who aren't going to receive very well because they simply can't hear properly. Listening is making meaning from the sound. It's a conscious process. It's not natural. And indeed, we don't really teach it very much. Listening is a skill, and I'm afraid to say it's a dying skill. It's being challenged. I mean, of course, architects do have ears. The question is, do they use them in their designs? The answer in a lot of cases is no. If you think of education as watering the garden, which I think is a reasonable analogy, we are wasting a lot of water. Because if you damp the room down, the children behave differently. They get quieter, because in a society where people don't listen, it's very difficult to start understanding each other and having empathy. The benefits of doing this, quite simply, we have a better educational system because people learn better. The health of everybody involved is improved, and the behavior of the children is radically improved as well. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you very much for listening to me today. I hope that's stirred you up. I hope it's given you lots of ideas. And I can't wait to hear what the rest of the speakers have to say. Thank you for listening.